My name is Amelito DeLusong Jr. I'm in the Drexel School of Biomedical Engineering, Science and Health Systems. My project here is about designing and characterizing porous gelatin methacrylate hydrogels for biomaterial wound regeneration. One of the big things that medical US patients face today are chronic wounds. And chronic wounds are modulated by these immune cells called macrophages. And that's sort of like the focus of Spiller Lab, my mentor, Dr. Spiller. Macrophages transition between phenotypes called M1 and M2, and they regulate wound healing. And dysregulation can cause chronic wounds or even fibrosis. And so biomaterial therapies are employed to modulate these phenotypes so that they like transition properly in order to like heal properly as well. One of the designs of biomaterials in order to help with the effectiveness of modulating phenotypes is the physical property of the biomaterial itself. There are other methods like drug delivery or composition of the biomaterial, but I wanted to do a more non-drug approach, and so I created a porous biomaterial. Porous scaffolds have been known to incite tissue regeneration and like cell growth on them, which helps regenerate tissue as well. And so that's what I did. But when a synthetic, according to research that I've read, there were synthetic hydrogels that were made that were porous that helped elicit a little bit of macrophage behavior, but there weren't that many naturally derived hydrogels. And so that was my focus for gelatin methacrylate. This sort of started out as an experiment with my PhD student mentor, but there was a certain inconclusivity with it. And so it was sort of put on to me to make a porous hydrogel, because her hydrogel was giving inconclusive results, and they thought that maybe when you compare it to the scaffold that's supposed to give the same results, it's porous. Maybe that's like the thing that's changing it. And so they gave it to me to design a porous hydrogel and characterize it. I characterized it with light microscopy using image J analysis. I also did some oil tests to see for interconnectedness and such. Results show that my pores weren't interconnected and that the pore distribution was very similar between 11% air integration and 20% air integration. By the way, my method of creating the porous hydrogel was sort of using a syringing method where I syringed back and forth the gelatin methacrylate and air and phosphate buffered saline to create these porous hydrogels. And what I found in pore frequency was that, and sorry, pore distribution was that the size of the pores were actually very similar in terms of distribution, but the difference that was very comparative to the two results were their frequency. The 20% air integration had about 80 more pores than the 11% air integration. And so moving forward, what I'd like to do is run a PCR to test for macrophage behavior. A PCR would be, so what I do is I seed cells onto the hydrogels, M0 macrophages. Those are the sort of like initial macrophages that turn into the phenotypes, the special phenotypes. And so I'd seed those macrophages onto the hydrogels, and then I'd wait like 3 days, and then I'd lysate. Lysate sort of means to break down the cell, and then we do an analysis on the gene expression. So we analyze the genes, and then it's these genes that help dictate whether or not the phenotypes are M1 or M2. Well, I had an info session actually. I didn't really know much about the STAR program. When I applied to Drexel, I did see it in the application, but I didn't really think much about it, so I didn't apply. And then I talked to a couple upperclassmen, and they were like, yeah, I did the STAR program, it's great, like I learned so much in research. And where I come from, I didn't have that much experience with research. I'm from an island in the Pacific called Saipan. It's like 7,000 miles away. And I wanted, the reasons why I wanted to get into biomedical engineering in the first place was because my parents wanted me to be a doctor, but I wanted solutions that like I knew from the deep down, and I knew that research was that place to go. And so I thought of biomedical engineering, and because I didn't have that much experience, I chose Drexel due to the co-op system. I was like, I want to do research, so let me check up on this STAR project thing. And then I applied and I got it.